sounds the call to come together, and united we shall stand. Let us live and strive for freedom in South Africa, our land.
Okay, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. So please take your seats. And the umpires will give their final word to the players, and we'll be underway for the final game of day number two here at the 2015 South Africa. In charge out here, Wayne Barham and Rom Shatter for South Africa. In the women's chukka, Carly Hicks the number one, Jean Hacklin the number two, and Cecilia Jacobs the number three, and Natalie McClarty the impact player. For New Zealand, Kyla Hill the one, Stephanie Takarangi the number two, and Beth Peaker the number three, and Nikki Scharf the impact player. So the players just warm their ponies up, and we'll get underway with this last game of day number two. South Africa and New Zealand. Time on the court, ball's in, it's up the front. Who's first to see it? It's going to be picked up by a number two shirt. Stephanie Takarangi now. She pops a pass across there to Kyla Hill. Hill with plenty of pace on up the quarter way. Fires a bounce down. There's goal number one of game number four. And there it is, 1-0.
Righto. New Zealand opening up their account there. A very quick goal. 30 seconds and the first goal of the fourth game is ready between the PVC piping. They line up on the Durban side of the field. Umpire Wayne Parham throw the ball and the ball sails it back. It's Salisha Jacobs. Salisha Jacobs with the ball now. Looking to link up with the number one and Kelly. Kelly's powering away downfield. Calls for the ball. Salisha offloads, but Kelly's in the 30-yard area. She's disc on the dance floor there trying to get a team on the scoreboard. And Kelly Higgs is a successor there. Goal number one for the South African side.
End-to-end Polocrosse, one for New Zealand, one for South Africa. Chukka number one. So now they go back to the far side of the field there. Ball's down the tunnel, it's out the back. So umpire Rob Shatter puts it in out the back. The threes get a look at it. Neither of them can pick it up now. On the offside, no, no, no. Out over the far sideline, that one's going to go. So the umpire says no control, so we'll line them up. They take all six again. Down the tunnel it goes this time. This time Cecilia Jacobs for number three for South Africa. She makes her way downfield now, just directing traffic through the rush hour traffic out here. She's got to make her way down. Pop a pass across to Higgs. Deep into New Zealand defenders over there. Away she goes now. Jacobs got to get this pass across. Who were number one there? In Kaylee Higgs. Higgs riding out in front. She's going to be met there on the line by Beth Peaker. But at the moment, Jacobs a pass across. No, she decides against it now. Jacobs this time, the little flick pass across. Higgs takes it in. Got to get away from Peaker. Beth Peaker and Kaylee Higgs do battle down there deep in South African territory. 2-1 to score. Chukka number one now. She just works around looking for a gap in this defence. The high one, the low one. 1-1 the score, Chukka number one now, working and making it work hard. Beth Peaker, Kaylee Higgs ducks in behind the overhander. Goal.
Oh, great little bit of play there from Kaylee Higgs. Kaylee Higgs putting in the overhand, not wasting any more time. They'll trot back to the halfway mark. 2-1 the score in South Africa's favour. Umpires have a bit of a discussion there in the field for with the New Zealander number two, Stephanie Takarangi. Stuart Neal, all the way from Australia, being hard at work, officiating all the games, making sure everything goes like clockwork, keeping all the umpires in order. Right, I see a couple of New Zealand ladies trotting off to the right-hand side. I think they're going to have some tending to in the horse department.
Oh, yeah. No, they put a new one on there. Right.
Right, it looks like Nikki Shaft is coming in the place of Stephanie Takarangi. Right, so they'll line up on the Durban side.
Yeah, sure.
The ball goes in, sails to the back of the line, and who's going to be first? It looks like Celicia Jacobs. Jacobs goes down, and she gathers a beautiful pick up there, takes a bit of timber from the number two, Nikki Shaft. Long pass through to Kaylee Higgs, the ball gets dislodged, goes to ground. Who's going to pick it up first? It's Jean Acklin. Jean Acklin coming in with a blunder of a pick up now. Now she's going to link up with the number one, and Kaylee Higgs. Kaylee Higgs does the loop around the pass, doesn't go to hand, and now the number two, number one for the New Zealand side, that's Kyla Hill, young Shane Hill's younger daughter. Takes a whole heap of timber there, the ball goes to ground. Who comes up with it? It's Celicia Jacobs. Kaylee rides away into a bit of open real estate, takes the pass from Celicia. Now she's working away in the goal scoring area. She's got to get past to number three and Beth Pika. Kaylee just works the real estate, looks for an opening, ducking, diving. Beth Pika not giving her an inch. She's going to close down the open space, make Kaylee work for these goals. Kaylee moves to the left-hand side of the field, looking for an opening. Stops, lines up a bit of popping, goes with the overhand shot at goal, sails between the sticks, and that's goal number three for the South African side.
Looks like we just have a bit of time off, but making it work for that one. Number three out there in Beth Pika. 3-1 the score, chucker number one. South Africa leading New Zealand. They go back to far side of the field now. Rob Shatter, the umpire from the United States, puts it down the tunnel. It sits there for the ones and twos. Picked up this time, yes it is, by the number one, Kayla Hill. She rides into a green and gold wall of defence now. It's picked up there by the number one, Kaylee Higgs, away. No, she's seeing black at the moment now. She flicks a pass. Whistle on, whistle, whistle, whistle. So it would appear to be in favour of South Africa. Late stages of chucker number one, 3-1 the score. Kaylee Higgs to restart play. She puts a little one out in the offside, sits up for her nicely. Back to the left she goes. She can be marked up once again by Pika. Now the cat and mouse game down there. And it looks like a bit more time off. So ensuring the protection of these ponies is paramount. And of course, being pulled, borrowed horses supplied by the South Africans. We must ensure the safety and well-being of these this great horse flesh out here. So just tidying everything up. And looks like we'll bring in the impact player through the racket of Natalie McLarty. So bring in both impact players in chucker number one. The quick changeover. So McLarty, her first touch for this game. Right in front to make it goal number four. Four plays one, chucker number one.
Right, Natalie McLarty coming in substitution of Kaylee Higgs. Obviously a bit of a problem there with the horse. They'll line up on the Durban side of the field. Umpire Wayne Parham to throw the ball. The ball goes in. Goes to the left-hand side. Who's going to pick it up first? It's Beth Pika. Beth Pika the ball now. Look, offloads to her number one in Kyla Hill. Kyla Hill can't gather. Natalie McLarty cleans up. Natalie McLarty the ball now. She gets ridden off there by Kyla Hill, but evades the tackle and makes her way upfield. She's got Beth Pika to avoid. Over the 30-yard line she goes. She snaps it. Now she's got to put it in a big left turn, get past Beth Pika. Beth Pika comes in the right of Natalie, makes the break, shoots the underhand shot at goal. And that's goal number five for South Africa. 5-1. Righty. A big warm welcome to all the people on YouTube. Polocrosse watching it for the first time. I hope you enjoy it.
So only one goal in New Zealand in chucker number one. They go back to far side of the field. Umpire puts it down the tunnel. It's out the back. We get to see the best of threes once again. Cecilia Jacobs. Jacobs, shall we race her against the clock? She's going to come down towards a quarter way. Flicks the pass across. McLarty. Goal number six they have. A great goal there to McLarty to make it six plays one. There's chucker End of chucker number one. We've got official score of 6-1.
Hopefully put on a good display of polocrosse for us all here today. Right. Right, they line up on the Pietermaritzburg end of things. The ball goes in, it sails out the back side of the line, and it looks like it goes straight back into touch. They'll reline it up again, the umpire on the far side. That's Rob. Umpire Rob will throw the ball in. They line up. Umpire puts it in, it sails out the back of the line, and who's going to come first? It's a deflect, and McClarty goes down for it. Graham McClarty picks up the ball, he's opening up his charge and heading downfield. Over the 30-yard line, he goes in, he snaps it, traps it, eyes out the sticks, shoots the over and shot at goal, sails between the pipes, and that's goal number 7 for the South African side in the second chucker.
Seven, one, chucker number two. So we see the best of the women, the best of the men in mixed bowl across. Ball's in, drops the twos, the threes, it's on the deck. Going to be picked up there by umpires, whistle on. The men in black and white, they're always right, the umpires. Wayne Parham and Rob Shatter. So he says we'll take all six and have another go at that. Ball's in this time, a bounce about the same spot, picked up by Stencap. Yanni Stencap, it hooks in the racket. It's going to go Skywood underneath that one. Jared Richardson now. Richardson, he's got to get down. He rides into a wall of defense, and there's his number one. Shane Hill says put it over the top. So they've successfully done what the South Africans just tried to do now. Hill comes up the quarterway, fires a bounce down. He'll be marked up here by Stencap. Yanni Stencap, he looked at having a swing at the racket. Shane Hill, the captain of the New Zealand side, the Golden New Zealand to play 7.
Radio. Action attractions, yeah. 5 goals of difference. It's still early stages. First chucker of this game. The ball goes in on the far side of the field. Who's going to come up with it? It looks like Yanni Stencam having a digger. He can't gather it. It's Jabon McClarty. Graham McClarty has the digger. And it's still rolling. And it looks like it's gone into touch. Right. Umpire Rob Shardo on the far side. He's adjudicated that ball to be kicked out by a horse. So it'll be a neutral line out on the far side. Right, the ball goes in, sails out the back of the line, and runs the South African side. Who's going to be a first? It's that man, Steenkamp. Jan Albert Steenkamp with the ball now, looking for his number one, and Graham McClarty. Graham McClarty doesn't loop around, he's got the ball now. Graham McClarty looks for a channel upfield, waiting to open up his pony. Finds a channel, ducking and diving, moving to the left-hand side of the field. He's got the number 3 and Jared Richardson to contend with now. Graham in the 30-yard area. Takes a bit of timber there from Jared Richardson, and a big whistle there from the umpire. And it looks like a free goal awarded to the South Africans.
Two plays, 8, near side of the field, McClarty. McClarty got one to shine up his teeth there. And now it's going to go in. The eagle eye of the twos there flicked the ball straight back. The umpire, he says, I'll take all 6 of you. We'll try again. Ball's down the tunnel once again. Now on the ground, McClarty had an eye for it. Has he got a racket for it? Yes, no, maybe so. Still on the ground now. Picked up by the number 2 there, Jesse Kiriopa. Whistle, whistle, whistle. So the players just voicing their opinion. The umpire says, that's nice. So there it is in the racket of Shane Hill. A restart play, the skipper for New Zealand. And look at the close and personal experience you get out here if you wear one of these national representative shirts. Now, it's in the racket of Shane Hill. There he is. Travis Tim giving him not a little but a heap. Now, Shane Hill says, you better come and help me out a little bit. Travis Tim riding me hard. The captain, the young gun, Shane Hill up the quarter way. Fires it downhill. Had a two goes at it. He might be first back to it. No, Stink Cap. He picks it up now. The number three for South Africa. Turnaround. McClarty, he says, I'll take it. No, Stink Cap says, we'll go fast. Cruise control, 125. The speed limiter hitting now. McClarty out in front. Richardson late to the scene. McClarty! Goal number 10.
All right.
10 plays two, chucker number two. Wayne, here it is, mate. It doesn't get any faster, harder than this. And where would you rather be on a Saturday afternoon?
No, there's literally nowhere I'd want to be. I've waited 4 years for this. And here it is. This week felt like it took the same time as the previous 4 years. And yeah, we've got South Africa versus New Zealand. In Shongweni. Right, the ball goes in, sails out the back of the line. It's going to be a first. It looks like it's their man, Steenkamp. Steenkamp has a dignity, can't gather it. Travis Tim goes down. Shane Hill coming around, but Steenkamp does the loop around, and big whistle there from the umpire. Right. Looks like the ball's been given to Shane Hill. Right, Yanni in wait in the New Zealand scoring area. Shane Hill plays a nice and safe one into the right-hand side of the field. Shane Hill with the ball now, looking for an option past the big man, Yanni Steenkamp. Yanni Steenkamp. Wait, and it's an interception, unbelievable. Yanni Steenkamp. Steenkamp with a classy interception there, and big whistle from the umpire, and I think a free goal was awarded, if I'm not mistaken, by the hand signal of the umpire.
Okay, we get underway. Chucker number 211 plays two. Ball down the tunnel. It's going to be picked up here by, wait to see what number's on the back of his shirt. It looks like it's number three, Cecilia Jacobs. A pass to McClarty. McClarty out in front. And there comes a quick one. No time to waste. Look at that one. 15 seconds and a goal to South Africa. 12 plays two. Chucker number three.
Right, here we go. Third chucker. Second chucker for the ladies. Right, they line up on the Durban side of the field. The ball goes in, sails out the back of the line. It is going to be a first. It looks like it's going to be Silisha Jacobs. The number three is going to have a dig at it. It's the Beth Pika. Anyway, Kyla Hill. Kyla Hill has a dig at it, and she comes up with it. Kyla Hill, the number one for the New Zealand side. She opens up her charge and heads downfield. Now she's got Silisha to contend within the 30-yard area. Whole host of South African players and block her out and make her do a U-turn. Kyla Hill over the 30-yard line she goes. She's got Silisha coming in like a missile there on the far side of the field. Kyla Hill looking for an opening. Silisha Jacobs closing down a bit of space there, making things difficult for Kyla Hill. Kyla Hill weaves away left to the field, looking for an option. Kyla Hill. Turning, getting away, evading a bit of stick swing from Silisha Jacobs. Shoots the underhand shot at goal. And that's goal number four for the New Zealand side. Goal number three, sorry. Goal number three for the New Zealand side.
So the gap on the scoreboard, no indication of the quality of Polocrosse out here. Both sides putting on a great display now. We go back to far side of the field over there with umpire Rob Sharp. Now the ball's in. It's blocked out by a number two shirt there in Jean Hacklin. Hacklin now. She just sits up about the halfway mark. Going to get a pass across here to McClarty. She'll be hard pressed up there by Beth Pika. Hacklin, a right hand wheel out of trouble from the defense here. Nikki Sharp. And look at the job Beth Pika's doing on McClarty. So just working around. Hacklin waiting. McClarty comes out into center field and says, I'll have to deliver mine. and male today. Now, McLarty, she ducks under a bit of stick there, comes up the quarterway, ducks under the racket of Pika, and great horse positioning there by Beth Pika. She just forced the error, and Nadia McCarty carried over the 30-yard line. Pika now to restart play. A big lofty one out on the outside now. She just left-hand wheels out of trouble. The big chestnut pony, another right-hand wheel. Oh, it's a good wheel. It falls out of the racket. She should be first to it, though. Oh, pick up by Pika. She picked that one up. She wouldn't have been able to see it when she got it now. Hill says, I'll take the mail today. Around the front, Kyla Hill gets plenty of horse flesh here from McCarty. She's gone beyond the point of no return, deep down the far sideline, and it's Kyla Hill. Kyla Hill looks to get around the front of Jacobs. No, she's blocked up now. She says, we'll just go back the drawing board, try and find a gap in this solid defense of the South African number three, Cecilia Jacobs. Working around a left-hand wheel, looped at the angle shot. Jacobs blocks her up now. They go back down there. Waiting to make a move here. Kyla Hill, a bit of pace on. Figure of eight around the front. No angle shot there. So great job here by the number three, Cecilia Jacobs. Kyla Hill right in front. The angle shot. Oh, Jacobs gets a racket to it. No goal. Waved away. Great work there by the number three. Great job by Cecilia Jacobs. So showing the quality in these and the depth in these South African number threes. We saw that from Steenkamp last chucker. Now Jacobs puts it long and hard out in front. Plenty of pace on. We're still going around and around and around. It's stolen by Kyla Hill down the far sideline. The number two in Nikki Schaaf takes Jacobs for a ride. Kyla Hill gets a bit of room to move now. She just checks the pony up. I do believe I heard a whistle in there somewhere. Amongst the hell on hooves out there. So she's advancing the New Zealand troops right in front of the goalpost. The high one right in front. Kyla Hill. There goes goal number four. Four plays 12. Chucker number three. A long innings between goals there, Wayne. Very good quality polocross out here.
No, it's the best, eh, Harry? Two teams putting everything on the table today, wanting to win. Saw New Zealand dig themselves out of the trenches yesterday. South Africa, they were still looking for a win. And it goes out the back. Who's going to be at the first? It looks like she can't dig it. Beth Pika. Beth Pika comes up with the New Zealand number three. Having a classy game out there. The ball's dislodged. It goes to ground. Who comes up with it? It's Gene Hackland. Gene Hackland with the ball now. Gene Hackland puts the offload through to Natalie McLarty. She can't get there. There's a bit of a switcheroo there. And Celicia Jacobs comes up with the long pass through to Natalie McLarty. Natalie McLarty picks it up now. Natalie McLarty here. Make her way upfield. Takes a bit of timber there from Kyla Hill. And the ball's dislodged. Natalie McLarty comes up with it. Drives a pony around the front of the... Shoots the underhand shot at goal. 13 goals to 4.
Great job by McLarty. Had it, lost it, got it, gold it. Ball's in, it's down on the ground. It's going to be picked up. Yes, lovely pick up there by, I think it's a number two. Yes, it is in Gene Hackland now. Hackland wheels a pony around, makes a way downfield. Got to get this pass across to McLarty up the quarterway. The overhand pass across. Natalie McLarty now, the 180 out of trouble. She rides across the face of the post. Beth Pika right there to give her plenty of attention. McLarty, the high angle shot. Easy as 1, 2, 3. There it is. I'd say, Wayne, that'll be the end of chucker number three, and we got a scoreline of 14 plays 4.
Right, Harry, we're seeing a very different looking side.
Get back underway, chucker number four. The men take the field once again. Graham McLarty, Gavin Cocker, and Yanni Steenkamp. For New Zealand. Joe Richardson, the number one. Regan Gloyne, the number two. And Shane Hill, the skipper, in the number three shirt. Ball's in on the ground. Who's going to be first to see it? It's picked up the front by Richardson. Jared Richardson, and he's had a change of number on his back, and it's proven to be the better. Richardson around the front, and there goes goal number five. There may be a big change here by the coaches, Wayne. What do you think?
No, I think it's a very It's Travis is solid number three. He plays with Graham McClarty a lot in there for their regional club. They know each other. Solid replacement. Right, the ball's in there, scrumming for it. It's the number two. Number two for New Zealand flicks it up to Jared Richardson. Jared Richardson over the 30-yard line. He goes, he snaps it, traps it, shoots the underhand shot at goal. And Jared Richardson puts in goal number six for the New Zealand side.
And Wayne, what about the change out here for the New Zealanders? The 3-1, the 1-3.
Oh, that's... I don't know the backgrounds of these players, but I take it that the New Zealand coaching admin have got their plan here.
Ball's back in, underway up the front. We see it there for McClarty. Graham McClarty's out in front. He's out there like a startled gazelle on the savannah. He downs it. He traps it. He stands up in the Jason Lacey Boy recliner, and he fires number 15 home. 15-6.
Quick, cheeky little goal there from the South Africans. Gavin Cocker having a big scrum down there in the centre of the field. Right, ball goes in. McClarty in the front of the lineup. Graham McClarty. McClarty the ball now. Now he's looking for a passage to play upfield. Takes a bit of timber there from the number two, and a huge whistle there from umpire Wayne Parham. Graham McClarty will take the ball from the 30-yard area. No mucking about today for the South Africans. Anyway, over the, takes a little quick into the self, shoots the underhand shot at goal, puts in goal number 16 for the South African sides. They take a healthy 10-point lead.
There's some players out here that are certainly up for the back of the bone, Wayne. Far side of the field, ball's in, it's on the ground, whistle on. And what's he going to do here? Someone's done a little naughty there. And it's going to be in the racket of McClarty now. This is Graham McClarty out in front. He had a run around the front goal last time. He might just think about the same. No, the experienced helmet there of Shane Hill just sits off him. McClarty stops, props, chops. High one, low one. He loves that little dummy behind. Haven't seen him throw one from there this tournament yet, Wayne. Does he let him go from there in the club carnivals?
Oh, no. Graham McClarty, he'll put them in from anywhere. As soon as you turn your head, he basically throws. He's like a loaded gun, just waiting to pull the trigger. See a bit of cautiousness yesterday, and I think all of that's gone away, and you see the Graham McClarty evolves back. Right, ball goes in, sails out to back the line, and who's going to be out to first is that man, Shane Hill. Shane Hill has the lead, he can't get it to number two, Regan. He has a go to there, all scrumming down, the ball gets dislodged. He's going to pick it up first. It looks like it's Cocker. Cocker's going to have a go at it, and number one, and then Jared Richardson, he comes up with it, but there's a huge amount of whistle there from the opposite side of the field. Spotted a little bit of a trouble there, and looks like it's been New Zealand's ball. Down hit. Umpire signaling a down hit. The number one, and Jared Richardson played three in the previous. Jack has gone to the number one. He takes a nice little neat one to himself. Now he's got to get past the whole host of South African players. Right. Jared Richardson taking his time, looking for the right spot. Goes over the 30-yard line. Travis Tim meets him up there. Travis Tim, experienced campaigner, gets involved with Jared Richardson, drives him towards the sideline. Comes up with the ball. It's Travis Tim. Travis Tim over the 30-yard line. He goes, avoids a bit of timber there from Jared Richardson. Travis Tim driving his pony forward, looking for his number one inmate, Graham McClarty. Graham McClarty, the ball goes through to... Huge amount of whistle there. Anyway, saw a bit of it. Umpires having a bit of a board meeting there. Jared Richardson almost losing, going head over biscuit there and coming right over. But he managed to stabilize himself and get a bit of stability.
Ball's in, it's on the ground, it's going to be picked up there by Cocker, the captain now. Gavin Cocker, the captain for the SA, puts a high one underneath it. Travis Tim, around he goes. He says we might just catch the pony out. Plenty of pace under the hood of this pony out here now. He comes up the quarterway, got to get the pass across to McClarty. It's a bit long, a bit flat, a bit hard. Awfully close, the back line, out over it'll go. Now, Shane Hill to restart play from the back line. He just puts a little one out. 18 play six. Chucker number four. Now Hill. Oh, he's looked up. It's fallen out of the racket, but he's got it back now. Shane Hill. He's got plenty of work to do. He's missed the post today. He'll have to take this one down himself. Working out here, Jared Richardson. He's copping not just a little bit of heat from Gavin Cocker. Now he says, where's my player? I need him to come back and give me a hand. Working down here, Shane Hill. So he says, we'll come out into center field. Oh, it's a bit of a flat bounce and underground, picked up by Shane Hill. Now he says, we'll just put a little one over the front. Out in front he goes. Here comes a chase from McLarty. McLarty now. And look at the job Cocker's doing on Jared Richardson, making it awfully hard. His day's work today. And he's actually saved a goal there. Great defense by the South Africans on all fronts. And there comes the end of chucker number four, Wayne. 18 play six, New Zealand trails.
Of a pony change there for her. Kaylee Higgs in the number one jumper, and Jean Hacklin riding the Appaloosa looking horse in the number two jersey for the New Zealanders. Kyla Hill, Nikki Shaft in the number two, and Steph Takarangi. Right, yeah, it looks like we're just waiting for something to be sorted out, and then the game will get underway. Looks like everything's sorted out. I see the number one. Looks like Beth Peake has done a career change and moved to the number one. The ball goes in, and who comes up with it? It's looks like the sideline. Right. Umpire just getting lined up there. Waiting for the players to sort themselves out. He puts a ball in and it goes down onto the South African side. Who's going to be out at first? It's Kaylee Higgs. Takes a bit of time, and it's Celicia Jacobs who cleans up. Celicia Jacobs. Big whistle there from umpire Wayne Parham, and it looks like it'll be a South African's ball from the 30-yard area. Harry, different looking South African side this morning, afternoon, should I say?
From what, yesterday? Yeah, certainly a bit more confidence, and also they seem to be a bit more calm, relaxed. But I guess it is a bit easier to be calm, relaxed when you're 12 goals in front, not one behind. So, everything to gain out here, the South Africans. New Zealand with one win under their belt. So march down the other end. We're going to go in the racket there of Kaylee Higgs. Higgs puts a little one out to herself. She'll be marked up down there by Stephanie Takarangi. Now the angle shot over the top. Lovely goal there by Kaylee Higgs.
Right, a great little shot there. Have a dig at the goals there from Kaylee Higgs. Fortunately, play with her quite a lot at club level. Eighteen years of age from Richmond, KwaZulu-Natal, comes from a strong Polocrosse family, and it's Celicia Jacobs. Celicia Jacobs at the back of the line, looking for a number one in Kaylee Higgs. Long pass through to Kaylee. Interception there by Stephanie Takarangi. Ball goes to ground. Who's going to come up with it? It looks like it's Kaylee Higgs. Kaylee Higgs with the ball now. Now she's going to get past Steffi. Steffi Takarangi with the ball, just defending the goal-scoring area. Puts her stick up, avoids the South African overhand. Kaylee moves to the right-hand side, shoots the overhand shot, and the goal waivers signal the no goal. Unfortunate miss there by Kaylee Higgs. Steffi Takarangi takes the ball now. It'll be her Her free throw from the 30-yard line. She plays a nice little quick one to herself. She's got Kaylee hot on her heels. Steph Takarangi charging upfield. Steph Takarangi avoiding a couple of plays. Looks to line up a number one and Beth Pika. The long pass through to Beth. The ball goes astray and it's rolling. Beth Pika keeps it in the field. She picks it up on the second attempt and Beth Pika doing a lot of ball control there. Very well played there by Beth Pika. Now she's just got to get past the very experienced Alicia Jacobs, the number three, the stalwart. Played in 3 World Cups. Celicia Jacobs keeps Beth Peake away. The ball gets dislodged and goes to ground. Jacobs will have a dig at it. She can't get it. And it looks like it's rolled out. Celicia Jacobs. Ball from the 30-yard line, a miss at each end. And a long pass through to Kaylee Higgs. Kaylee Higgs collects, opens up a charger, cruising downfield. Heads down over the 30-yard line. She goes, she snaps it, traps it, shoots the underhand shot at goal. Goal number 20 for the South Africans.
Yes, we saw them do the Polocrosse waltz down the far sideline, side by side the whole way. But Natalie McLeody leans out of the saddle and puts on goal number 20. 20 play six. They go back now, the far side of the field. Umpire waits for them to call them in. Ball's down the tunnel now. Drops the ones, the twos. Just picked up by New Zealand number three. Yes, and the racket is Stephanie Takarangi now. She just sits up about the halfway mark. Got to get a pass across here to a number one in Beth Pika. Takarangi gets a stick there from the number two. And Jean Hacklin, now back in the racket here of a New Zealand shirt. It's gone in, it's on the ground, awfully close to the 30-yard line. Stolen possession here by the South Africans. In Cecilia Jacobs now. Jacobs, she just works around down there. And here comes Beth Pika to give a bit of attention. But around she's going to go. Now let Tapani run. Plenty of pace on the long bomb. Let the ball do the work. As she goes out in front, here's McLeody. Takarangi right there on the 30-yard line. McLeody, the overhander. Oh, she's hit the side. She's hit the goalpost. I bet you she won't be able to do that again, Wayne, even if you paid her. On the ground, it's picked up by Takarangi. Yes. Picked up by Stephanie Takarangi now. This is the number three for New Zealand as she works to edge out into centre field. Lefty and then a righty, the 360, the 180, the 520, and around and around and around the merry-go-round. She's got her in a world of trouble deep out there. McLeody giving it a little bit of heave. Kaylee Hicks, sorry now, and out into centre field. She gets a bit of room to move. The flick pass across there. It's going to be taken by Nikki Sharp, the number two downfield. The pass teamwork makes the plan work. 3-2-1. Pika up the car, quarter way. Downs it now. She'll be marked up here by Jacobs. But Pika, she looks around the front. Hooked in the racket. Two missed goals, end-to-end polocross. Tail stages, chucker number five. We'll draw breath. They make this one hurt. Jacobs. Puts a little one out to herself now. Clear the area. For those of you new to the rules, that's what you do when you miss a goal. You have a clear the area from the opposing number three. Look at the pace once again. Lightning speed of Jean Hacklin. On the appy, the Appaloosa. Now it's in the racket. She says we'll flick a pass back here to Kaylee Hicks. Kaylee Hicks now, downfield directing traffic. There it is, ladies and gentlemen. Put your hands together. That's probably the last we'll see of these women out here. And a great display of women's bowl across, Wayne. Right, New Zealand side. We've got Jared Richardson in the number one jersey from the previous chucker. Number two, Jesse Kiriopa in the number three jersey. The ball goes in and it's
That man, Jared Richardson. Jared Richardson snatches it in front of the lineup, but he gets a whole heap of trouble there from two South African players. Takes a whole heap of timber there, taking more hits than a blackjack table. Getting hard ridden there by McClarty, and the ball's dislodged. It goes to ground. A big call there from the umpire. Not sure what the problem was. He's got Yanni Steenkamp in white. Jared Richardson plays the Arsenal one to his near side there. He collects it. Now he's got Steenkamp. Get past the big man, Stone Cold Steve Steenkamp. Jared Richardson drives his pony forward, tries to go for the unhand shot. Yanni Steenkamp blocks it out. Jared Richardson taking his time. Jared Richardson works the 30-yard area. Drives his pony around the front. Yanni Steenkamp blocks out. Uses the overhand shot at gold. It goes to the left of the PVC piping, and it'll be Jan Albert Steenkamp's ball from the 30-yard line. Jared Richardson receiving a hell of a time there in the 30-yard area. Right. Quick little flick there to that man, Travis Tim. Travis Tim, Fanyan Tim. The pass goes back to Jan Albert Steenkamp. The long ball through to McClarty. It falls a bit short. It goes to ground. Who's going to be onto it first? It looks like it's going to be McClarty. McClarty gathers it up first, shoots the underhand shot at goal. And that's goal number 21 for the South African side. Little great bit of interplay there by the South Africans. It almost didn't come off right, but all ended well for them.
Yes, well, that's what they say, Wayne. Teamwork makes the plan work, and that's a great display of that. The plan out here is to get the goal on the board, and there you have it through goal number 21. 21-16, chucker number six, balls in, down the tunnel. It's going to be a race between the twos, the threes, the fours, the fives, picked up by the South African number two, Travis Tim. Travis Tim now, holy smoking Joe. Well, No words I can say will explain that one, Wayno. You had to see that one to believe it.
I'm just hassling the cameraman. I want to get that in slow-mo. See, the big thing about slow-mo is it doesn't actually show you how fast it actually was. Anyway, back to play here. And it sails out the back of the line as that man, T. Tim. Travis Tim looking for his number one in Graham McClarty. The pass goes through. McClarty puts a big overhand in it. Goal number 23 for the South African side.
Yes, you won't catch no big screen replays here. So feast your eyes upon what's out here in front of us. And they're really starting to fire. All cylinders running out here for the South Africans in chucker number six. 23-6, New Zealand held scoreless in probably two chuckers. Ball's in on the ground, still down the deck. And Yanni Steenkamp there to pick it up now. Steenkamp sees McClarty. McClarty says, put it here, put it out in front. They hit it. They're on the run here all the way to Durban. 24 play six.
Oh, the guys really linking up well out there. It's all coming together in the sixth chucker. They've had a great game. Great game today to played more of their free-flowing style polo cross. Get in the corner and bang it in the goals. They line up on the Durban, on the Pietermaritzburg side, should I say. Right, just, we're in the second stanza of this chucker. Right, ball goes in, sails to the back of the line. Who's going to be at first? It's Steenkamp. Steenkamp with the ball now, looking for his number one to link up with that man, Graham McClarty. Graham McClarty drives his pony forward, takes a pass from Steenkamp through the PVC, popping it goes. That makes it goal number 25.
So with a time off, but Wayne, you're right in saying this is the South African side playing more like we're used to seeing them get around out here.
Yeah, no. South Africans, especially Graham and Yanni, they they thrive with the free-flowing polocross. And yesterday they looked a bit conservative, and they played well. I can say that, but they're playing a bit of catch-up throughout the game. Today we see that free-flowing polocross that we all love to watch, and a great display from the South African men today.
So, as we mentioned, Wayne looking after these polocross ponies that have been kindly donated out here and put up to...
Big thank you to every single horse owner that's got a horse here at the World Cup. It means a lot.
Yeah, so it's good you mentioned that in contrast to somewhere like Australia where you might see 4,500 registered playing members across the country. So it is a great job by the South Africans to produce this many good quality horses. So we get underway, chucker number six, ball's in. Where is it? It's out the back, it's there. Offside, Kiriopa had a go at it, can't pick it up. Still down, picked up by Tim. Over the top, there's the man. Shotgun out in front, McClarty. Go.
Great little bit of interplay. We've got about 1 minute left in the clock. The boys aren't taking their foot off the pedal. They're going to keep knocking at the door. It's not over until it's over. You've got a job to do. They're getting the job done. Right. Ball goes in. Who's going to come up with it? It looks like the number two for the New Zealand side. He has the diggity. He can't gather it. It's McClarty. Graham McClarty with the ball now. Graham McClarty charging upfield over the 30-yard line. He goes. He snaps the traps. He can't gather it on the first attempt. The ball goes awry and over the back line. Ladies and gentlemen, come down to the commentary box and buy yourself a program if you don't have one. It's got a brief on every single player playing at the World Cup. Oh, we see a long pass there from Jesse, the number three for New Zealand. It goes to ground. Who's going to come up with it? It looks like it's Jesse Kiriopa. Jesse Kiriopa with the ball now, charging upfield, trying to link up with his number one, and Jared Richards, and the pass goes through to Jared. He can't get on the first attempt. Bangs it into the goals, and that's no goal, but the end of the chucker. Put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen. Great game of polocross. I'd love to see you all here, and we can have a chinwag strap on the feedback. Have a drink.